Good morning, Brooke Scholars, and happy Tuesday. I'm excited to welcome you all back for our second day of our ABC Countdown to Summer. More on that in just a moment. First, I want to hear your voices telling the world how powerful you are. Get ready.
I know I can be what I want to be. If I work hard at it, I'll be where I want to be. I know I can be what I want to be. If I work hard at it, I'll be where I want to be. I know I can be what I want to be. If I work hard at it, I'll be where I want to be.
Say, way to go, team. I had so much fun yesterday getting pictures of you celebrating our very first day of our ABC Countdown to Summer. Check out this awesome picture I got from Leah. It looks like there are two unicorns in this picture. I hope you brought your favorite stuffed animal to learn alongside of you yesterday. Today, we get to celebrate Beach Day! Whoops. I forgot. Hold on 1 second, scholars. I gotta get ready for this amazing beach day ahead. All right, that's better. I got my beach towel, my sunglasses for those sunny day. I also put on my sunscreen, want to make sure I'm being protected from all those sun's rays. Got a little extra here because I always get burnt on my nose. Tamika's ready for an awesome day at the beach. I hope you brought some attire for your special beach day. You don't need to be in a bathing suit because it's not exactly warm enough today. But you can celebrate alongside of us. Make sure you send in pictures to me or to your teachers, just like Leah did yesterday. I can't wait to see what you've been up to. And check it out. All day today at Morning Mo, we'll be enjoying some waves, enjoying the sun, getting a little wind in our hair. I feel more relaxed already, scholars. Have an awesome day learning. Remember, pretend you're at the beach today alongside me. I'll see you there. Let's jump right back in with some shout outs. Your teachers have a ton of shout outs today on this special beach day. First up is from kindergarten because Miss Home Miller has a shout out for Avian. Avian has been working really hard on his goal of improving his handwriting, especially in his spelling videos alongside Mrs. Crow. His handwriting has been getting better every day. Say, way to go, Avian. Staying in kindergarten right now because Mrs. Crow has a special shout out for J. Cole. J. Cole and his family sent Mrs. Crow pictures of his learning every single assignment, every single day last week. And each picture showed J. Cole with a big smile on his face because he loves growing his brain and getting smarter. Say, keep it up, J. Cole. Next, Miss Pearson has several shout outs. She's been noticing some excellence in the Williams College Eves. First, she wants to shout out some scholars who have also, just like J. Cole, been sending in pictures of their work every single day. Those scholars are Addison, Jislaine, Mahad, and Leah. Say, way to go, team. But Miss Pearson has another shout out for her scholar, Dewan. Dewan showed leadership last Friday during their special Zoom celebration of his birthday. He led a class-wide scavenger hunt during that time. Williams College Eves had so much fun because of it. Nice leadership! heading up to first grade now because Mrs. Lee and Miss Doherty have a special shout out for Kendrick. Just like J. Cole and those Williams College Eves, Kendrick sends in pictures of his learning and the pages of his YouTube workbook from first grade every single day to Mrs. Lee and to Miss Doherty. Not only does that make their days better, it shows that Kendrick is growing stronger each day and preparing for second grade. Keep it up, Kendrick! Staying in first grade because Miss Flaherty has a special shout out for Nate. Nate joined his Georgetown Scholars on Epic, where they've been reading some pretty cool books lately. Don't forget, you can log under Epic too. Ask your teacher if you want to know more because there's so many awesome books there and your teachers get to see what you've been reading. Say, keep it up, Nate. Heading up to second grade now because Mick Skidmore has a special shout out for Destiny. Destiny has been showing so much self-determination. His internet was causing some issues for his learning last week and he couldn't get on Zoom. So he asked Mick Skidmore for the Google Slides and did all of the work that he missed. Additionally, he gave me a call on the phone to help him figure out Nearpod. That shows a lot of self-determination and leadership for his own learning. He doesn't make any excuses to fall behind. Say, way to go, Destiny. I'm really proud of all of those scholars, and I'm really proud of you. Have you been growing your brain? Have you been getting better each day, even while we've been away? Exactly. And that's why we get to do fun things like celebrate Beach Day together. I want to tell you how we're going to continue that celebration now. But before I do, I want to read to you because it's Storytelling Tuesday. I found two poems that reminded me of you and our special beach day. Come with me. All right, welcome back to my reading nook, scholars. Today I'm joined by Tamika on her beach towel. Got my sunglasses ready, but making sure I can read all the words to you. Today I picked a special book that some of you might be very familiar with. This book is called Just Like Me, and it was written and illustrated by Vanessa Brantley Newton. This book is really important in Brooke history because many of the poems inside were recited by Brooke Mattapan, kindergarten first and second graders at our Live at the Apollo just a few months ago. I'm gonna read one poem that wasn't recited that reminds me of our beach day and the light that each of you create. Then I'm gonna read a second poem that might seem very familiar to you. Are you ready? Let's jump in. Okay, the first poem I'm going to read to you is called The Day I Decided to Become Sunshine. I know today's a little bit cloudy and it's not exactly like going to a real beach, but this poem reminded me of our beach day. Each of you have the power to create light. Let's read what Vanessa Brantley Newton wrote. The day I decided to become sunshine. The day I decided to become sunshine. In my own world, everything changed. I decided to shine my little light into the darkest corners of my community. I decided to be a light by holding a door open for others to come through and to shine the light of kindness into my every move. The day I decided to become sunshine, I felt like I could change the world. Give me a Me Too sign if you're a world changer. I'm gonna read this poem one more time because it's short. And I want you to think about how you can become sunshine. You can't actually become a sun, but how are you going to spread light and make the world a better place? Let me read it one more time. The day I decided to become sunshine, in my own world, everything changed. I decided to shine my little light into the darkest corners of my community. I decided to be a light by holding a door open for others to come through and to shine the light of kindness into my every move. The day I decided to become sunshine, I felt like I could change the world. How are you going to change the world, scholars? I want to hear you. How are you going to light up the world and make it better? I can't wait to hear what you have to say and what you'll do to make our world a better place. I love that poem, and it reminded me of our beach day, creating light for others, even when it's not exactly warm or very sunny today. I wanted to read a second poem that many of you might remember from Live at the Apollo. This is one of my favorite poems Vanessa Brantley Newton has written, and I bet you're going to be familiar with it. Give me a Me Too sign if you remember Dan and Trinity M getting on stage, those first grade scholars from BU. Let's read the poem that they recited. The poem is called I Am. I am a song longing to be sung. I am the shine belonging to the sun. I am the sweetness in the breeze. I am the roots of the big oak tree. I am the fish swimming in the sea. Results of ancestors, prayers to be free. Instead of reading this a second time, I want you to see Dan and Trinity in action. Check out how they remembered the poem and made it their own. Hit it.
I am a song longing to be sung.
I am the shine longing to the sun.
I am the sweetness in the breeze.
I am the roots of the big oak tree.
We are the fish swimming in the sea. Results of my ancestors' prayers to be free.
All right, scholars, I loved seeing Dan and Trinity so enthusiastically sharing that poem with others. They did an awesome job. And they also repped their roots that day. They dressed to impress on stage, representing their excellence. Tomorrow, we'll continue our ABC countdown to summer by representing your family's excellence. Tomorrow, we'll be celebrating the letter C. And C, on our day celebrating C, we will celebrate your family's culture. Tomorrow, dress in an outfit that represents your family's culture. You could see what Dan and Trinity wore for Live at the Apollo. Check out these other pictures of Brooke Mattapan scholars dressing to impress and representing their family's culture. First up, take a look at Ariel and Dan representing their Haitian culture, and Trinity B representing her pride in Trinidad and Tobago. There's Joe Anthony and Kylie representing their pride in the Dominican Republic. And of course, Mauna and her big sister Mauli demonstrating their pride in Ghana. Who could forget Jamari representing Jamaican excellence on stage? And of course, Excel and Peculiar looking beautiful representing Nigeria. Last but certainly not least, check out Mayana, Maxwell, and Kayla demonstrating their pride as African Americans. Just like today, when you'll send me in pictures of you celebrating your beach day, tomorrow send me in a picture of what you are wearing to represent your family's culture. I can't wait to see. Remember to send me a picture at this number right here. All right, scholars, I'm so excited to welcome you back here tomorrow for our Culture Day, our continuation of our celebration of our ABC Countdown to Summer. Don't forget to dress in clothes that represent your family's culture and send me and your teachers pictures so we can show them to your entire team. I can't wait to see. Today, don't forget to send me a picture of your beach attire and how you're celebrating even when we can't go to the actual beach. Today, to finish up our celebration at the beach, I found a song that reminded me of how much fun we would have if we got to go to the beach together. I'm not sure if you know this one, but I'm putting my sunglasses on, grabbing my pretend surfboard. Say, hit it! Can you surf? Let me see. We're gonna take real soon. All right, scholars. I had a great day with you. I can't wait to continue our ABC countdown to summer tomorrow. Join me back here. I'll see you then. Bye, scholars.